So in the last video in this series I did, we downloaded MMANA-GAL download and we installed MMANA. So I got it running here and here it is. So today I thought we'd do a simple dipole. Again, this is going to be under 5 minutes. I'm going to show you a new tool. So the first thing we're going to do is going to head to the geometry tab and we're going to pick a dipole. And let's say the dipole can be for the 40 meter band. We'll start off with a flat top dipole going north south. That will be on the y axis. So we'll do 10.2 meters one way and minus 10.2 meters the other way. Now there's a drawing tool in this and it's actually clicking this button here. If I hover over it, the tooltip is wire edit. And there it is. Hey, there's some buttons over here on the right. We're currently in the 3D look. And I think with the control or shift button, we can move that around. Okay, the control doesn't do anything. XY, that's us looking straight down on the top of it. XZ means we're on the X axis, which is left to right, and Z's going straight up. And then YZ, now we're looking from the left-hand side, or the right-hand side, with Z going straight up. And you can do stuff in here that would be more difficult to do if you had to actually do the numbers. So we can right-click this, for instance, and divide the wire into three pieces, for instance. And then we can move this around. So this button over here is draw a new wire and this one is edit a wire. So I'm just going to grab this point here. I'm going to move it over to there. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a little bit of wire in the very middle that doesn't move. And that'll be our feed point. Okay. So we can zoom in a bit here and I can make that fairly small because we don't really need to come back to this. There. And then it'll tell us how long that is over here. The length of that is 0.2 of a meter, which is about 8 inches. So it's a bit too big, really. Doesn't matter. This is just a model, isn't it? Then we hit the OK button. And now you'll see it's actually created some new stuff. All right. And if I go to the View tab, there it is. So that's wire 3, it says over here. This one says wire 1. So the middle one is going to be wire 2. So what I'm going to do is wire to center. That's where our coax is going to go. So that's all I'm going to do. I'll view that, and there it is. It means I've cut it into three because we can make it inverted V in a minute. All right. Hit the calculate button. This is for, well, I haven't told it over here actually yet. It might be easier to do 7.2 megahertz now. So when I go over to here, it'll bring it over for me, 7.2. It saves me typing it in. So it's currently on the ground. So we'll put it up about, say, 8 meters, 24, 25 feet, 8 meters. And we'll make it out of copper wire. Now, it doesn't make much of a difference what we make it out of here. But anyway, start. We've got a bit of an SWR issue going on. It says 2.4. And... but I'm not going to show you this bit, so just stand by. Because I'm going to show you that another day. I don't want to confuse you now. It's actually, that length is resonant on 7 megahertz dead, right? And you'll see there. SWR 1.2 to 1. Okay, and there's our far field plot for our 40 meter dipole. And, well, that's easy, isn't it? And which is why one of the reasons, if we just go down around here at 45 degrees, and that says the gain figure is 2.3 dBi there, and over here it's 6 dBi. So we're about a 3 dB difference between north, south, east and west. Which is not a lot, right? You know, S8 signal, you're not going to know if he's 3 dB down or not, right? So don't worry about the configuration north, south, east, west, if it's for a 40 meter dipole. Right. We'll convert this for 20 meters in a minute. Now, in the main, most of us don't have a flat top. We've got a tree somewhere and it's normally inverted V. So we'll go over here, we'll unzoom this a little bit here, We'll take a note of roughly how long these things are. It says each leg is 10.1, and I'm going to sort of inverted V it. That's 10.3 there, so we're going to go down lower in frequency. 10.3. I'm going to zoom it in a tiny bit, and I'm just going to make these tiny bit shorter. 9.8. You know, you can get a bit fussy with this. Okay. I would have thought the frequency would go up now. 2.28. I reckon it's probably resonant about 7.2 now. Start. It is 1.18. So has inverted V-ing it made much of a difference? So at 45 degrees off the horizon, you know, daytime 40 meters, you know, roughly where does this go? I've got, 3.1 there, 5.7 there. So there we are. It's actually equaled out a bit, isn't it? It's not much in it now. When I made the vertical the last time we did this, we can have a look at it there. And there it is. Now, if we wanted to convert this for 20 meters, how do I do that? Well, you could either raise the height by 2, or if you really want to be fussy, we can scale it. So the new frequency wants to be 14.2, let's say. It will redesign all this, and there's a trick. We can get rid of some of the decimal places one day if we want to, but we'll do that when we go under the hood. At the moment, that's about 4.6 meters. What's that, 20 feet somewhere, just under. Good. It's still at 8 meters height. It still looks like this. 8 meters at the top. And in fact, the bottom of these is droops down 1.5 meters, 5 feet, whatever. So now let's have a look at that. If SWR's wrong, honestly, we could fix it by adjusting the lens. It's not going to make an iota bit of difference. When we look at the far field plot. So this is our far field plot now. So elevation, we're after a little bit of DX, 10 degrees. Not heavy DX, just, average, roughly where's my signal going. And we can see we've got this. Now it's important. Now you need to choose north, south, east, west, if it's a fixed dipole. All right, and this is at 8 meters. So if we went up half a wavelength, 20 meter band, so it's going to be 10, half a wavelength now, 10 meters up, inverted V on 20 meters, far field plot, elevation, heavy DX, half a wavelength off the ground. So that's now. That 4.7 there is roughly the same as a vertical, all right? So our best gain east-west is roughly the same as a vertical, which is why a vertical on 20 metres works a blooming well on 20, because you've got all of this, which the vertical is beating, all right, instead of that. So that's why we need to go above a half a wavelength. So if we went to, 40 feet, 12.5 metres, 40 feet now, and we can see, by the way, we've got this lump coming up in the middle, which is a bit of a waste. 5 degrees off horizon, minus 1.4 now. So now you get your east west, you'll be doing much better. However, from about here, there to there, you'll be a wee bit deaf. Good, you have now made your first dipole, and that's probably a little bit more than 5 minutes. I apologize. Next time we're going to make a sky loop, various loops, and then gradually we'll get deeper and deeper and deeper into some of the other tools. Okay, in case you missed it, I will put a link in the description to the first one of these. All right, and then stay tuned and we'll make some more of this stuff. All right, lovely. See you in the next one. Bye for now. Stop recording.